Hello everybody, my name's Sean, aka the Silver Fox, and today I want to demonstrate my DIY hobo stove. Okay, just going to turn it around so you can see. Right, what I've made this from is a stainless steel thermos flask. This part is the outer casing. This cup is the inner part that would have contained your drink. Okay, so I've cut through the top, taking the two sections out. What I've got is metal tent pegs, which I've drilled the holes through and I've put it through. Okay, now at the minute I've got some wood in the bottom there, just getting going, and I can just keep feeding sticks in from the top at the minute until it gets. Until it gets nice holes in there, until it gets nice and hot. But what I've also done is I've put holes in on the side so I can drop it right down, and then I can use it with my hexi block, which when it's all stacked up away, basically this fits inside, the hexi blocks fit inside. I then got a pot scourer, which I put inside as well. A bag of tinder goes inside as well. My stainless steel cup fits inside as well, as long as two lids. Okay, one for the cup, one for the pot. And then what I intend to do is I want to experiment today and I'm going to boil up some water in the cup, which I'll place on the top like so, and then put some water in this cup, which I'll place on top again, and I'm hoping that the heat from the second pot will generate enough heat to heat the water in the top. Okay, so first thing first, add a little bit of water, enough to make some dinner, and put a lid on, put that in there, I can hear that fizzing away already in there, so I can just keep feeding my little bits of stick in the front. Now this should only take 3 to 4 minutes to get this water to a boil. And all you want to do is make the sticks fairly short, obviously so they fit in there nice and neatly. Obviously it's worth having a good pair of leather gloves. The ones I always wear, these type of gloves, are heavy duty gardening gloves. I buy these out of Home Base in the UK, which is like a DIY store. Okay, that's going away. Right, while that's getting going, I'm going to put this on the top. And see how that goes. Log in. Nice stable. So what I did, I drilled a series of holes around the bottom, and they're obviously to generate a draft from the bottom, keep it fed. And what you'll find when it actually burns itself out, there'll be very little ash. It's very, very efficient on the amount of fuel it uses. Do you want to get back on telly again, do you, Bill? Okay, I've got it's nearly at boiling point, not quite, but nearly, and that's probably going to be burning 3 to 4 minutes. I'm probably not going to need much more water in there, that many, much more fuel in there, so I won't put any more in now for the time. And some food, I've got one of these dried pre-packed foods. These are long life, these best before September 2009, so there's over a year on these. Okay, this one in particular is smoky bacon, peas and mash. Okay, so now we're getting the water to a boil. Simply tip the content into your cup. Right, what you can actually put in water straight into this bag, and then you spoon it out of your bag, saves on you washing up. But for today, I'm going to boil it up in the pack, in the cup. Take that off. Now I've got my cup. Wait a second, lift that up a little bit higher. Just for the cup. Put that back on top. A little bit more fuel in there. Okay, the cup, the fire is basically out, it's just embers in there now. But I just want to show you. I'll just put a couple of sticks back in, a couple of small ones to start with. Just want to show you just how hot it is in there and how... My all-in-one hobo stove. And to try and demonstrate, that is how much ash, hopefully you can see that, is left from all that wood we just burnt. Okay, so it's a very, very, very efficient cook system.